Good morning. Welcome to Victory, where it's not only a place, but it's your position and place in Christ. Amen. That we know Him, walk with Him, love Him. Amen. So this morning we're going to open up with this song, and we are so blessed to be a part of his family. Amen. Are you a part of His family today? Amen. Let's sing this. Stand My Ground. Yes. That's what we're going to do. The Word of God says that if My people who are called by My name will humble themselves and pray. There's a lot more to that verse, but we're going to humble ourselves this morning. There's several people that we want to lift up in prayer, close people that we love and people that are on our hearts today. So we just want to stand and just agree with me this morning that the Lord says if we pray, He will answer. Amen. If we ask, we shall receive. If we seek, we shall find. And if we knock, it shall be open. So, Father, today we come before You in the mighty name of Jesus with boldness, God. You said to enter in with boldness to the throne of grace. And Father, we thank You that our help comes only from You. So today, Father, we lift up the Braden family. Carson, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we speak healing over their bodies, Lord. We speak healing and help over them, Lord God, that every infirmity has to bow to the name of Jesus. every sickness must bow to the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we speak your word over this family, and we thank
you,
Jesus, for what you've done in them and what you're as you're doing through them, Father.
Yes, Lord.
And we give you praise in Jesus' name.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Jesus.
For the answer, for the glory story. Amen.
Yes.
And we pray for Randy.
Yeah.
He was on Facebook this morning, a friend, and his son was in an accident. Holy Spirit, go to the situation. We've been asking
Lord.
You, touch this young man. Touch him. Bring healing and help and hope to his body in Jesus' name. God, that you would protect him from anything that would try to arise from the situation. To give doctors wisdom on every side in Jesus' name. Father, and for BB, that you continue your healing in her. For the Zachary family, Lord God, that you will, we speak to the situation,
Jesus.
And we tell you to bow your name. Every name that is named is under the name of Jesus. So, Father, we speak the name of Jesus over the Zachary family and BB's life. God, we thank
Jesus.
You for touching them right now. We thank you for the Gish family, God, that salvation would come, that God, truth would permeate and love would rule and reign in this family in Jesus' name. For the elite team, God, that you would just show these families how to love their children, how to love one another, God, and may Christ be lifted up in
Jesus.
These situations
yes,
as
Jesus.
The ball teams, Lord.
Yes.
For whatever reason, when they meet on Sundays, God, we
Jesus.
Ask that you will help them, Lord. Help
yes.
them to know you, God. And Father, you just make a way for these families to be in church in Jesus'
yes,
name. Father, we pray for all the events that are coming now and in the future to this place, to VWC, God. We plead the blood of Jesus over this place, amen,
yes,
over our lives
yes,
and over all the ministries, everything you desire to do. All that you've done and all
yes,
that you
Father.
Continue to do and all that you're going to do that's coming, Lord. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Now, if you would like to give today to the ministry, we would certainly appreciate it, right, Pastor
Amen.
Mike?
Amen.
You can go to VWCDixon.org. And there is a link to give. You can link on there and give to the ministry. We give God praise. And the Lord bless your seed as you give today in Jesus'
yes,
name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's sing worship to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We've just come to praise you, Lord. Come on, let's sing it. We've just come. We've just come to praise you, Lord. With that for a minute. Yes, Lord. Let's just sing a new song for a minute to the Lord. We've just come to praise you, Lord. Yes, God. We've come to give you glory. Glory, glory to your name. I just came to praise the Lord. Just came to praise you, Lord. I just came to praise your holy name. I just came to praise you, Lord. Now let's sing. We've come to praise you, Lord. We've just come to praise. just come to praise you, Lord. Oh, I want to thank you, Lord. Thank you for being so good. You are wonderful, and we bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord. We've just come to praise you, Lord. Me. Oh, how he loves you. did not owe an iota debt I could not pay. I needed some.
Thank you.
cause all the praise, honor, and glory. Hallelujah. So this morning as we get ready for the Word, amen, we love Jesus. The Word here, amen.
Jesus.
And we appreciate our Pastor Mike. It's going to bring the Word today.
Jesus.
God bless. Let's receive the gift of our pastor. Amen. What a blessing. The Lord gives pastors, evangelists, prophets, teachers, and
the apostle, prophet, the apostles, pastor, teacher,
yes.
and evangelist.
Yes, yeah, amen. So we receive Five-fold your gift ministry, this amen. Morning. Fivefold gift.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Well, this is the day the Lord has made. It's so we got the AC or the refrigerator on this morning, so my sinuses are trying to drain on me here. Praise God. I had to had a message. Praise God. Amen. Well, maybe get Donna to run and gather that up there for me. Flow with the Holy Ghost, she says. Amen. Amen. I believe that we need to flow with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Well, this morning, appreciate those of you that be joining us today. You know, victory is not just our name, it's our position in Christ. And, you know, we don't always feel victorious, but, you know, that's why we make the declarations of faith that we do, because the devil, he's always trying to make us feel less than we are. You know, if we're a child of God, then that's what we need to stand on, is that we are who God says we are. Amen. Trying to get set up here. Praise the Lord. Might be going the wrong direction. Amen. Amen. Well, be patient with us out there. Praise God. As we get set up. Ha, ha, ha. Hallelujah. If you would leave a prayer request this morning, you can leave it right there on Facebook. And let us know how you're doing. We appreciate those of you that do join us faithfully. Some folks catch us later in the week or later in the day. But whenever you catch us or whenever you see this, the Word is still the same. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. So we trust that that the same God who is right here with us right now, will the same anointing will be right there with you whenever you watch this at the time you do. But just know that we know that God answers prayer. He's faithful. He is a faithful Father. He's a faithful God. And He said that He would never leave us nor forsake us, that He is always with us. And I like 1 John 4:4. It actually tells us that greater is He that is in us than He that is in the world. So thank God for that He'll never leave us nor forsake us. He is in us. That greater, let's make a declaration of faith this morning. Greater is He that is in me than He that is in the world. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Greater is He that is in me than He that is in the world. Well, this morning we're going to talk, continue speaking out of Psalm 34. Psalm 34. We've been talking out of Psalm 34 for a couple of months now. And I think that I find so much in a passage. You know, it's not the quantity of scripture that you get in your heart. See, some people will, and it's okay to read through the Bible in a year. There's nothing wrong with that. But you know what? If you just read through the Bible and you don't take time to digest it, I think if you took about 20 minutes a day, 15 to 20 minutes a day, you could read through the whole Bible in a year. And that's great. But what are you getting when you actually read it? Are you just reading through it like it's a novel or it's a newspaper, or you know, what are you getting out of it when you do read it? That's the question. So, you know, we're going to just park on Psalm 34 for a while because it's such a powerful passage. And, you know, as we've said in the past few weeks, this was a passage that David wrote after he had, behaved as though he was insane when he was before Abimelech. And, you know, I'm not going to go through that whole story again, but after David was got out of that situation, you know, one of the first things he says here in Psalm 34, and I'm not going to start reading through the whole chapter again, but he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. You know, if we didn't get anything out of this passage at all up to this point, that is such a powerful point, that I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be on my mouth, in my mouth. And you know, the thing is I think David realized after he did what he did, that he actually trusted in himself more than he trusted in God at that time. Because he could have believed God. I mean, look, we got Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. We've got Daniel, who was rescued from the lion's den. If God could do that for them, didn't David believe that he could be delivered from the hand of his enemies? You know, evidently in this time, he realized something about himself. So what he does to recover himself, he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. And that's where we've got to be. We've got to be at a place in our walk with God that when hard times come, they don't overwhelm us. When we are faced with adversaries, when we're faced with circumstances that seem insurmountable, that seem bigger than life, you know what we have to do is we have to go back and rely on the fact that God is good. He'll never leave us. He's always with us. He's always for us. And better than just being Emmanuel, which means God with us, better than that is God in us. So no longer do I have to have somebody come and tell me what is right from wrong. I have Christ in me to convict me of sin before I even fall into sin. Because Jude says he's able to keep us from what? He's able to keep us from falling. So we really have no excuse with God when it comes to our walk with God, because God can keep us from falling because of the Spirit of God that He has put in us when we were born again. Amen. Now thank God for the indwelling of the Spirit of God, for regenerating our spirit and making us new. What does it mean to be, how do we become a Christian? Romans 10, 9 and 10. And first, starting at verse 13, he says, they that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Well, in Romans 10, 9 and 10, it says he says you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. There, you know, Christianity is called the great confession. And not only is it a great confession, but it's the great confession that possesses something. We don't just confess, make good confessions because it's just something we do to entertain ourselves. We make confessions of God's word over our lives because we believe they are true. And as we believe and confess God's word, we know that our world around us is changed because of the word that we believe, we receive, we confess. We believe it in our heart first, because see, you know, it doesn't do any good to confess anything about God. You don't receive anything from God just because you confess it. You don't receive any of the blessing from God because you confess it. You don't receive the protection. You don't receive provision. You don't receive anything from God just because you confess it. The root of the issue is what you possess in your heart, what you possess really in your soul. See, what's really in your heart is what you can truly confess and possess and receive from God. That should be just very simple. We've got people that totally misunderstand the word of faith and totally misconstrue and totally speak evil of what they don't understand. You know, I've even had one person say they used to teach the words of faith, and they got out of it because of whatever. They got some kind of better revelation than what God gave them. But, you know, I have to say, they probably, honestly, you don't, you know, and John said this. He said, if they depart from us, they were never really of us. If they depart from us, they were never really of us. So if you depart from something you say you even taught, good chance is you really didn't have it in your heart. You really didn't believe it. You were just parroting what you heard others say. So, you know, we don't attack what we don't understand.